This is Richard. His parents are doing okay.
And this is Paula. Her parents, not so much.
Richard's house is warm and dry. His shelves are full of books, and his fridge is full of food.
Paula's house is full of people and not much else. It's damp and noisy, and she keeps getting sick.
Richard's parents will do anything for their baby. Good boy. Clever.
And so will Paula's. That's why they're working two jobs.
Richard goes to a great school. Well-resourced, good kids. His teachers love their job.
At Paula's school, the class sizes are large. The school is underfunded and looks it. Her teachers are tired, stretched thin from the stress. Oh man, I need a new job.
So maybe we can see why the expectations set for Richard. B+. Oh dear, we need to get you a tutor.
Might be slightly different from those set for Paula. B? Hey, not bad.
And over the years, all these little differences, parents paying for university,
juggling work and polytech, still getting in debt,
they start to add up, to build into something bigger. I have friends working there. I'll have a word and get you an internship. Thanks, Dad.
You should be finishing your studies, not looking after me. Dad, you're sick.
And because each little difference sneaks by unnoticed, yep, the loan is approved. Congratulations.
Look, we just can't help you. Maybe try Easy Finance?
Then maybe Richard starts to believe that he deserves to be on top, that he did it all himself. Oh, you're Roger's boy, right? I've heard good things. Keeping my eye on you.
And maybe Paula starts to settle, learns to know her place. Okay, you've got the job, but I'm watching you, sweetie.
What is the secret to your success?
Excuse me? But I hope not.
Less whining. More hard work, I say. I'm sick of people asking for handouts. No one ever handed me anything on a plate.
I really hope not.